I've heard a couple of people say, you know, we should force the government to think about public housing as a right. And I think this movement has taught us we can't rely on our government for anything. So it has to be a push from the people from below. So I think about it, in the wintertime, we have a ton of spaces that we could occupy as houses and defend people's rights from being evicted, from being foreclosed upon. One of the greatest scenes, I think, from Michael Moore's movie in Capitalism is the scene where the elderly woman is getting evicted and all people occupy the house and defend her right to housing. And that is the only way we're going to win housing as a right, is if we defend it, not rely on someone else to defend it for us.
On the Occupy units, we'll go back to the Lathrop example. At Lathrop, again, 925 units of low-rise, beautiful, brick, well-landscaped housing on the north side of the city, where now there are less than 200 residents. As I mentioned, the city has systematically deoccupied Lathrop. They've just very recently moved all of the residents who had lived, some in scattered units on the south side of Diversey, to the north side of Diversey, saying that they need to consolidate the heating for the winter season. And what that does is creates buildings now that have no one in them, and they will, of course, slowly self-demolish, right? When nobody lives in them and the city of Chicago is not maintaining them, they will crumble, and what will happen is people will say, well, these are eyesores, so of course they should be demolished. These are uninhabitable. So at Lathrop, again, where the residents and the resident leadership are committed and courageous to preserving Lathrop, there is an opportunity to join them in what they are doing, which is occupying that development and insisting on maintaining the presence of public housing residents there.